Welcome everyone to this time of Selihot. I'm really happy to be here with my dear friends, Uri and Yair, who are joining us from Jerusalem. Lizzie, who's joining us from the east side of Manhattan, and Dan from Brooklyn. So we're happy that we can be together and spend a few moments examining and singing and reflecting and doing some soul searching, examining some piyutim and some melodies, some pretty ancient, to accompany us on this journey of penitence and self-examination and repentance. Our tradition says that when Moshe came down from the mountain after having received the tablets and the Torah, and he saw the people dancing around the golden calf, he channeled God's anger and sense of betrayal, and he smashed the tablets. And God got very angry, and Moshe was very disappointed. And then the tradition says he went up to the mountain for a second time, and this happened on the first of Elul. From the first of Elul to Yom Kippur, when forgiveness was granted, Moshe spent 40 days up in the mountain trying to persuade God to find forgiveness for the people. And this is the journey of Selichot. It's 40 days in the Sephardic tradition, fewer days in the Ashkenazic tradition, of waking up very early at dawn, which is a time that is propitious for reflection and self-examination, for chanting in the very early hours of the day when everything is quiet, there's no disturbances, there's no movements, just the internal movement of each person to try to get deeper and deeper into one's heart and into one's whole. and to one's soul, and to find there the strength and the courage to see oneself in truth and to ask for forgiveness. And so we're going to do this journey together now, and we're going to begin with a beautiful piyut, Ben Adam Malecha Nirdam, which quotes from the end of Yom Kippur, from the book of Jonah, who fell asleep in the boat. And so here the poet is saying, Ben Adam Malecha Nirdam, wake up. Wake up, don't be spiritually asleep, but be spiritually awake, particularly at this time, and seize this opportunity to ask for forgiveness and to return on tshuva, to go back to your essence, and to return to God, to return to one another, and to return home. We are in exile, we are away from all the places we need to be, so this is the time to wake up and to do this work. Ben Adam, Malecha Nirdam.
Ben Adam, Malecha Nirdam, Kum Kera Beta Hanuni, Shefoch Esiha, The Rosh Seliha Me'adon Adoni Merechatz U'tehar Be'al Te'aha Be'terem Yamim Poni
U'meherarut Le'ezra Lifnei shochen me'onim Umi pesha Ve'kam v'sha Be'lach Uf'echad me'asonim Anashe'e Shimcha yode'e Yisrael ne'emanim
Lecha Adonai בושת הפנים עמוד כגבר וכגבר בדות על חטאים יח אל דרוש ולחוב דרוש וכפר על
לעולם לא נעלם ממנו נפלאים בכל מאמר אשר יאמר לפניו הם נקראים המרחם הוא ירחם עלינו כרחם אב על בנים
אדוני הצדקה ולנו ובושת הפנים לך אדוני הצדקה ולנו ובושת הפנים
Shalom. I don't know if it's good morning or good evening, exactly what time you're going to be, but we're here beyond time and space, going to these ancient texts that repeat themselves year after year for so many hundreds of years all around the world. And now, each time, I think an opportunity, like Rabbi Roly said, to see where we are, like with ourselves, with our communities, with our humanity, with our tradition. So this ongoing conversation. And I think awakening is it's a process. This whole 40 days are 40 days of awakening, you can say. It's really a very, very big challenge to be awake. Not only early in the morning, that's for itself is a challenge. But as what he said in an inner way. And this next song that we're going to sing, this next piyut that is coming from the Algerian tradition of Rosh Hashanah, starts also with a very interesting point, with the individual arising, singing in front of the community, in front of God. And this, again, this conversation which you find yourselves moving from the individual confession, prayer, into being part of something bigger, but then not forgetting your voice all the time. These voices coming together as individuals, as communities, and beyond that, as people. So a beginning point here is to be present with your voice, with your individual voice, not to hide, to be present, to try and face yourself and face God with your community.
Akum leshorem vezemer ha'orem lelo heitehilati neredo ranen vera Hanen ve'azil dim'ati
Yish'el shav'i yema'er yish'i yahish yeshu Ati yechaper ma'ali irpa ma'ali imhol rishati
bekuri aneni Elohei tzidki Ushema tefilati El bashkarada etereada Verol tachad veini
Etet toda בעומדי בעדה ישרים תאמים רחום בחסדך יפנה לעבדך ותיתן לי רחמים
האל למענך, אזכה בדיניך, ומחל נשני. בך אדוני חסיתי, בקוראי ענני, Elohei tzidki Ushema tefilati El melech yoshev al kisei rachamim Umitnaheg b'chasidut Mohel avonot amom ראשון ראשון מרבה מחילה לחטאים וסליחה לפושעים עושה צדקות עם כל בשר ורוח לוחם רעתם תגמול אלו רטלנו לומר מידות שלוש עשרה זכור לנו היום ברית שלוש עשרה
مش وضعت لعناب مكادم وخن كتوب بتوغتاخ ما يغد أدوناي بعنان ويت يتسعي موشام ويكرا بشم أدوناي بشام ויעבור אדוני על פניו ויקרא אדוני אדוני אל רחום וחנון ערך אפיים רב חסד באמת נוצר חסד אלפים נושא עוון ופשע וחטא ונקה וסלחת על עווננו וחטאתנו ונחלת לנו
When I first started going to Selihot early in the morning, I had this feeling, like, what is this feeling that I've had before? And it was, oh, I'm going to the airport. I'm getting up early for an early flight. And I think that Selihot had the same sense of both the journey of Elul that Roly spoke about, the sense of anticipation, the sense of anxiety, there are security checkpoints. And when you get to Ashamnu, when you get to the Vidui, which we're about to do, you're through the security checkpoints and you're at the runway to Yom Kippur. We will say this prayer all through Elul and we will arrive, having said it, at Yom Kippur. The Vidui, as Yair said, is both very personal and intense, but it's also said in the collective. And as a woman who married in the Sephardic tradition and was not raised with morning Selihot, feeling part and not part of the community was also part of this journey and the experience. No matter how welcoming people were, and they were very welcoming, but the Ashamnu was always, always personal and intense and real.
Ashamenu bagadenu gazalenu dibarenu dofi הבינו והירשנו, זדנו, חמסנו, תפלנו שקר. יצנו רע, כזבנו. לצנו, מרדנו, ניאצנו, שררנו, אבינו, פשענו, צרחנו, כישינו עורף. רשענו, שיחתנו, תיאבנו, תאינו, תיתנו.
I think we can all hear the brokenness. We reach a point when we get to the vidui, to the confession, of a very deep place in ourselves, of shame, of embarrassment, of reaching the darkest place in ourselves, the lowest place, whichever metaphor works, but really touching our fragility, our vulnerability, our mistakes, our imperfection. And there's a profound sadness there, I think, in having failed. And from that place, we rise to plead with God, not only for forgiveness, but also for blessing. We are going, I think, with the chutzpah, not just asking God to forgive us and to redress our record and to erase our mistakes, but also we go beyond that and we ask God to bless us and to give us all the things that we need so that we can try again and try to rise and try to thrive and try to do better next time. And so we have a prayer that is organized in the traditional Selihot compilation, which is according to the Aleph Bet, according to the Hebrew alphabet. And we have all sorts of requests. We have selected a few here that we place to God in heaven, to the God that is out there. You know, sometimes the metaphors of God are very, very close. And sometimes they're out there, they seem unreachable. But even there, we try to bridge the distance and we try to come close and to ask and to put forth all the things that we need. So we've selected a few here and we will recite them and we hope you'll recite them with us. And if you don't recite the words, at least say amen at the end of each sentence, indicating that this is also what you need as much as we need it. We all need it.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, שמע קולנו וקבל תפילתנו ברצון.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, hear our voices, accept our prayers.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, סמוך את נפילתנו.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, support us when we fall.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, עלה תפילתנו.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, answer us on the day we call you.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, צווה איתנו ברכותיך.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, grant us your blessings.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, צווה איתנו ישועתך.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, grant us your salvation.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, אפרח עולה עמך ישראל.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, heal our sick.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, תן שלום בארץ.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, grant peace in the land.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, תן צבא בעולם.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, grant abundance in the world.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, תן לחם לפי הטעף לשובע.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, may all the children of the world eat and be satisfied.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, יקון תפילתנו כתורת לפניך.
אלוהינו שבשמיים, may our prayers ascend like fragrant incense.
עננו אלוהי אברהם, עננו.
עננו פחד יד יצחק עננו
עננו אביר יעקב עננו
עננו הזוכרת רחל עננו
עננו בזכות מרים הנביאה עננו עננו השומע עליך עננו
מרן דוד עננו
עננו הענה בית רצון עננו
עננו העונה בעת צרה עננו העונה בעת רחמים עננו
עננו אלוהי המרכבה עננו
עננו רחום וחנון עננו
עננו רחום וחנון עננו אמן.
We are going to sing one of the most famous piyutim from the Selihot, Adon HaSelihot. In its chorus we are asking, חטאנו לפניך, רחם עלינו. God, we have sinned before you, have mercy on us. I wish to look into its tune. I would have thought that the tune will be of plea and request, that it will be slow and heavy, but the tune we sing starts slowly, yet when we get to the chorus where the reoccurring cry for mercy is, the mutual singing tunes faster and happier. How can we confess our sins, חטאנו לפניך, and ask for mercy, רחם עלינו, in happy tune? I think that the answer is simple. Our happiness is caused by the gift of תשובה, the possibility to go back and return to the previous state where we were before we sinned is a gift that God gave us, and that is why we're happy. We are happy because we can make tshuva, because of God's promise that he will have mercy on us and forgive all of our sins.
Amen, k'ni ratzon.
אדון סליחות בוחן לבבות גולה עמוקות דובר צדקות חטאנו לפניך רחם עלינו
Adur benifla'ot Vatik benechamot Zocher berit avot Chokek elayot
Ha
atanu lefanecha rachem alenu
tov umetim laberiot yodea kol nistarot kovesh leavonot לא חובץ לדקות
חתנו לפניך ועלינו
מלא תקיות נורא תהילות עולי החבונות עונה את הצערות
חתנו לפניך רחם עלינו פועל ישמות צופה עתידות פורס הדורות אוכב ערבות שומע תפילות דמים דעות חתנו לפניך רחם עלינו
Ahamana
de ane la ani e o ane na Ahamana de ane
Thank you. אבינו מלכנו חוננו ובעננו יהיה בנו מעשים
עשה עמנו צדקה וחסד
this short journey of us, of ours, today, of Selihot. We hope we have awakened the desire to return in Teshuvah, to do the work of soul searching. We certainly have awakened this amongst ourselves, I feel. We are friends who have spent many, many hours together in prayer, all of us here. And we turn now to the last piyut, Achot Ketana, which is the opening piyut of the prayers of Rosh Hashanah on the evening, the first evening of Rosh Hashanah in Sephardic communities across North Africa and the Middle East. This is the opening poem. It is composed in the 13th century in Spain. And it's a poem that talks about the Jewish people as a little sister that is at the mercy of her enemies, that is in exile, that is frightened and vulnerable, and that puts before God all these prayers for protection and for blessing. The little sister that seeks to leave behind the nightmare of exile and all the curses of the past, and to walk forward into a peace, a place, and a time of blessing, of fullness, of coming back home, and of wellness, and of peace. And so this symbolizes our most, I think, profound desires at this time, particularly now that we're facing so many challenges of violence, of illness, of so many problems that we face all over the globe, in Israel and here and all over the world. We're united, I think, in our desire, all humanity, to leave behind this year and all its problems and difficulties and yes, and illness and death, and to walk into better times together as one man, with God's blessing. Achot Ketana, Tefilotea, the little sister puts forth her prayer, and so do we.
Achot Ketana, Tefilotea, Orcha ve'ona te'ilotea El narefana le'machalotea
Tirchashana ve'kilelotea Shir ve'il dolim
ilechanai ad matai talim enecha v'tir'e zarim rochim nachalutea
ilechanai shana ve kilelotea akem mishif lut rosh mamelechet bevoregalut nafshahnitechet ocheru mezulut libashofet bedalidal mishkenotet ikhleshana kilelot
mataita ale bitkhani bor o bet kele o la tishbor eta flipele betzet hakelo e hatem vechale vechaloteha
ikhleshana vekilelote.
So at this point in Rosh Hashanah, in the evening of Rosh Hashanah, we're facing this year that is now ending with the sun that is setting. This year is setting. In this very special moment that soon we're going to enter the next year with the starting with darkness, you know, this very, I think, unique concept in Judaism that the day starts in the night, when the time of the unknown, the time of the unseen. So the sun is setting and we're facing the year. We're trying to giving our hope there that this year and its curses will conclude. Many things we're taking with us, but we can also allow ourselves maybe to depart from things that we can depart. And now facing the next year, the new year that is now approaching, and hoping for its blessings, for something new, for ourselves to renew, for humanity to find a place where it can renew itself. And a new blessing, we're hoping for a new blessing to come with the next year, with the new year. חזקו וגילו.
חזקו וגילו כי שוד גמר לצור חילו בריתו לכם ותעלו לציון ואמר סולו סולו מסילותיה
חזקו וגילו
איש הרגמר לצרוח יעילו בריתו שמר לחבת העלו לציון ואמר זולו זולו
May our prayers be heard and accepted, and may we all have a new year of goodness and blessing. Shana Tova to all.
Amen.
And thank you, my friends, Amen. For this Shana opportunity
Tova.
To be together.
Toda Rabba.